我这儿一会儿信号不好或者是不方便，所以我把今天主持人的这个权限交给那个 Krishna Kumar 麦代基。
好，
好的，谢谢。好好，那我们现在就可以开始了。
Om Jnana Timarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Militanena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschachya Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we're going through the sixth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, and we are on chapter number five, and we're hearing how Daksha offends Narada Muni.
We are now learning the Shengdian Bhojavatam, the sixth canto, the fifth chapter. We are seeing Daksha, Narada Muni.
So we heard how Daksha had offered the Hamsaguya prayers and give pleasure to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And the Supreme Personality of Godhead gave Daksha a wife, and he told him this woman will be able to, her womb will be able to give birth to many children. So Daksha is one of the Prajapatis, and so his desire is to produce many progeny to fill up the universe.
Daksha, he is one of the Prajapatis, so his desire is to produce many progeny to fill up the universe.
So Daksha conceived children in the womb of his wife, and the result was 10,000 men took birth. 10,000 male children were born from the womb of his wife.
Daksha 借助他妻子的子宫繁衍人口，最后他通过他的妻子得到了一万个男性的儿子，就是得到了一万个儿子。
These children are called the Haryashvas, and they were all of very good qualities, very saintly. And Daksha desired, as they grew up, he desired to arrange suitable wives for them, have them all married. So he told them, first of all, go away and do austerities, and when you come back from doing austerities, then we'll arrange your marriage.
Daksha 告诉这些Haryashvas, 首先你们先去做一些苦行，当你们苦行完了结束回来之后，我就给你安排婚礼。
So it happened that Narada Muni happened to see these young men. They had gone to a holy place to perform their austerities.
当哈尔亚什瓦他们去做苦行的时候，恰巧Narada Muni碰见了他们。
Yeah, they'd gone to a holy place.
他们去了一个圣地，在圣地从事苦行。
And they were performed because of the influence. The holy place was very good on them. It purified them, and they were able to take instruction from Narada Muni.
因为在那个圣地非常的净化人，所以也有利于他们从 Narada Muni 那里接受训示。
So Narada Muni told them that there's a place that there's a place where people go to, they don't come back. They go to that place, they don't come back.
Narada Muni 告诉他们，有那么一个地方，人们去了之后再也不回来。
And he told them there's a kingdom where there's only one male.
而且有一个王国，那里只有一个男性。
Of course, that one male is the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
当然，这一位男性指的是至尊人格守神。
And he has a kingdom. People who enter that kingdom, they don't come back. They never leave that kingdom.
那里还有一个王国，人们去到那个王国之后，再也不会返回。
So that kingdom is like the spiritual world, like Vaikuntha.
那个王国实际上指的是迷信世界，指的是外昆塔。
And then Narada Muni also described that there's a woman who is like a professional prostitute.
Narada Muni 后面还说到有一个女人，这个女人她是一个职业的妓女。
Right, that professional prostitute is like a person who has intelligence, but it's not fixed on anything. It's very unsteady, and it just simply desires sense gratification.
这个职业妓女象征着一个人的智力，但是她的智力并不稳定，她的智力总是专注于那些。
And there's a man who is the husband of this prostitute.
如果还有一个男人是这个妓女的丈夫。
Right. So if, you know, if a man has a woman who is like that, then he's not going to be very happy.
如果一个男人有这么一个妓女作为他的妻子的话。
In the same way, if we have intelligence, if our intelligence is polluted with material desires for material life, we'll never be happy.
同样的道理，如果我们的智性是被污染的，我们的智性总想着这些物质的感官快乐的话，我们也永远不会得到真正的快乐。
So Narada Muni is continuing to describe things to the Haryasvas, and he tells them that there's a river.Which flows in both directions.
Narada Muni 接着描述，有一条河，它通往两个方向。
So the Haryashvas, these sons of Daksha, 10,000 of them, they considered this statement. They considered what is the meaning of this statement.
Haryashva, 他这一万个儿子，他们了解这句话背后的意义。
And they considered that the river is the river of material nature, and it flows in both ways.
他们了解这个河流实际上指的是物质自然的本性，它以两种方式在流淌着。
One way flows, you get creation. Another way flows, you get destruction or dissolution.
第一个方向是。创造，第二个方向是毁灭，这两个方式是同时在进行的。
So if somebody falls into this river of the material nature, then the waves are very powerful and the waves will pull them down.
如果有人不知不觉地跌到这个河流之中的话，因为这个河流非常的湍急，所以它很难以挣脱。
And the nature of the river is that the river always flows fastest near the bank of the river. And so you'll never be able to get out of the river. So Narada Muni asks, what benefit do you get from doing activities in that river of Maya?
所以他们就询问到，他们就反问到，就是自我思考到，在这条玛雅的河流之中，我们从事这些功利性活动会有什么益处呢？
So we may be in the waves of the river of Maya, and we may also try to get free from the waves, but we come to the try to come to the side, the bank, the side of the river.
我们也许会被这个玛雅之河所淹没，但是我们也会挣扎着从这个河流中跑出来，想跑到岸上去。The
banks of the river are represented by knowledge and austerity.
到达这个河流的岸边，可以通过知识和苦行。But
the waves are very strong at the side of the near the to the side of the bank. The way the current is very strong, so difficult to get out.
但是呢，这个岸离这个河又是非常非常的远，我们要到达这个沙洲这个岸边是非常非常困难的一件事情。So
if we don't understand how we're being thrown around by the material nature, and we just simply do material activities, then it's all useless. It's a waste.
如果我们不知道自己是怎么样被抛到这个河流中的，而且还从事着这些短暂的功利性活动，那些都是毫无益处。Lord
Brahma describes in his prayers to Govinda, he describes that the material energy, the Maya Shakti, is personified by Durga.
Brahma 像主 Govinda 供奉的祷文中这样描述到，他说 Maya 的这个能量，他的人格化身实际上是 Durga。And
she is in charge of the creation and the destruction, and she acts under the direction of Govinda.
他掌管着这个物质世界的创造和毁灭，但他也是在至尊主的指导下活动着。So
if we fall in this river of Maya, then we get thrown around by the waves.
如果我们跌到这个玛雅的大河流之中，我们总是会被这个波浪拍过来拍过去的。But
if we surrender to Krishna, then Maya can also save us.
如果我们能够臣服于 Krishna的话，玛雅同样能够拯救我们。Krishna
consciousness is based on knowledge and austerity.
Krishna 知觉是基于知识和苦行的。
So every devotee, they do some austerities, and they also have to take knowledge, they have to learn, get education from the Vedic literature.
每一位奉献者都在或多或少地做一些苦行，而且他也在从伟达文献中获取知识。
If we want to get free from material life, we have to become a devotee.
如果我们想从物质生活中得到解脱的话，我们必须得成为一位奉献者。If
we just try to become a great scientist, there will be no benefit.
如果我们只想成为一位科学家的话，那也是没有益处的。But
if we take shelter of the material nature, then if we're caught in the material nature, then what is it? There's no benefit to being a great scientist or philosopher.
如果我们，if we're caught in the material nature. 如果我们被这个物质自然所卷走的话，就是摄入其中的话，我们又成为一位科学家，又有什么意义呢？
Science and philosophy are also, it's also material knowledge.
这些科学或者说哲学也都是物质的知识或创造。
So we have to understand how Maya works.
我们得了解 Maya 是怎么活动的。
And we have to understand how we can get free from the waves of this river of Maya.
我们也得了解我们应该如何脱离这种 Maya 的大河之中的这些波浪。
So that is the first duty of every civilized person.
这是每一个文明之人的首要的职责。
So Narada Muni said also, because Narada Muni was explaining to the Haryashvas, he said, there's a house made of 25 elements.
Narada Muni 跟 Haryashva 说，有一个房子由25种元素组成。
And the Supreme Lord, all the 25 elements, they come from him.
所有的这25种元素都来自于至尊主。
He causes their manifestation.
这因为至尊主是这些元素的源泉。
So if we just do ordinary material activities without knowing about the Supreme Lord, then there's no benefit.
如果我们从事这些短暂的这些活动，但是对至尊主一无所知的话，也是没有，那有什么用处呢？
Philosophers, scientists, they're trying to find out where everything comes from.
哲学家们、科学家们总是想研究到底我们是从哪里来的。
But they only try to understand by their own minds. They try to understand everything with their own speculation.They don't do it scientifically.
但是他们所做的这些研究只是通过他们的心意和推测，他们自我的进行思辨揣测出来，但而不是根据真正的科学去研究的。
In the Vedas, it says everything comes from the Supreme Lord.
根据伟达文献，一切都来自于至尊主。
The Vedanta Sutra says that.We should inquire about the Supreme Soul.
Vedanta Sutra, 伟达终极伟达经告诉我们说，我们应该询问有关至尊灵魂的事情。
So when we try to understand the Supreme, that is called Brahma Jignasa, or the knowledge of Brahman.
如果我们在询问有关至尊者的事情的时候，这种询问叫做 Brahma.
And in Srimad Bhagavatam, the Sutta Goswami describes that the absolute truth is Brahman, Paramatma, and Bhagavan.
在圣典薄伽瓦坛中解释到绝对真理的时候说，有 Brahman, Paramatma, 以及 Bhagavan 三个层面。
To the people who are neophytes,then they see the absolute truth as the impersonal Brahman.
对于初学者而言，他们认为至尊绝对真理是 Brahma 梵。
And to people who are like advanced yogis, they see everything as the Paramatma or Super Soul.
对于那些精进的瑜伽师而言，他们认为一切都是 Paramatma 超灵。
But devotees who are the most advanced, they know that the absolute truth is the Supreme Lord Vishnu.
对于奉献者，最高层面的那些奉献者来说，至尊的绝对真理实际上是八个万，他是至尊主威士。
So the material creation is all an expansion of the energy of Lord Krishna.
物质创造实际上都是至尊主能量的扩展。
Everything we see in the world is just an expansion of the energy of Krishna.
我们在物质世界看到的一切都是至尊人格所生各种能量的一个扩展。
Krishna is like a fire, and it spreads his light, the heat and light everywhere.
至尊人格所生像一团火。它释放着光芒和热量给每一个地方。
So the whole material world is the expansion of Krishna.
整个宇宙展示只是至尊主的一个扩展。
So our duty is to find out who is the supreme cause.
我们的职责要找到那位至尊的源头。
But if we waste our time and just engage in material activities, then it's just a waste. Everything is a waste of time.
如果我们做花很多的时间来了解这些物质的这些活动，从事物质的活动，这简直是在浪费时间。
Even you may be a great scientist or philosopher, but it's useless.
即便也是一个哲学家或者说伟大的科学家，这也是毫无用处。
If you don't know who's the cause of everything, who's the original cause, then your science and philosophy are of no good.
即便你是一个科学家或哲学家，如果你不知道终极的原因的话，也没有什么好处。
So Krishna is the original person, and he can only be understood by devotional service.
主 Krishna 是那位原初者，他只能通过奉献服务被了解。
Right. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, "Bhaktya mama bijanati yavam yas tasmin tadvataha." Only by devotion can I be understood as I am.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中说，只有通过奉献服务，才能了解一切背后的至尊。
So we have to understand the material elements and all the inferior energy of Krishna.
我们需要了解的是，物质元素只是主的一种低等能量。
And the living entity is the spiritual energy of Krishna.
而个体生物是主的。是主 Krishna 的灵性能量。
So everything, the material energy and the spirit soul is just a combination of the two energies of Lord Vishnu, Lord Krishna.
所以无论是物质还是灵魂，他们这二者只是至尊主的两种能量。
Yeah, we have the material body, that's the inferior energy.And we have the spirit soul, that's the superior energy.
我们有这个物质的躯体，这是主的低等能量。我们有灵性的灵魂，这是高等能量。
So we should study the creation, maintenance, and destruction.
因此我们需要学习创造、维系和毁灭，了解这些。
And we should try to understand that place where we could go without coming back.
我们还得知道那个能够去到之后再也不必返回这个物质世界的所存在的那么一个地方。
But because people are so conditioned, instead of trying to understand the spiritual world, they try to enjoy the material world.
但是人们是如此的受条件限制，他们没有花时间，不仅没有花时间去研究这些灵性的世界，而且他们用大量的时间去用于感官享受，在这个物质世界感官享受。
And people that are attracted to find happiness in the body of the fair sex and in the body of the women by making women dress without proper clothing, without covering their bodies.
他们总是想着在这个物质世界，各种激情的享受，比如。和异性之间的这种感官的快乐，希望女性穿得很少等等，这样让自己非常激情的一种享受。
So there's no benefit for these stupid activities.
这些愚蠢的活动没有什么真正的益处。
People have to take to Krishna consciousness.
人们需要 Krishna 知觉的。
But then Narada Muni had also spoken that there was a swan.And that swan is going to be explained now.
Narada Muni 曾经还提到过一只天鹅，接下来我们会解释这个天鹅。
So the Vedic scriptures, they describe how to understand Krishna.
伟达文献生动地解释我们应该如何去了解 from Krishna.
Krishna is the source of all the material and the spiritual energy.
To Krishna 是一切物质和灵性能量的源泉。
So the Vedic scriptures explain about these two energies.
伟达文献也解释了这两种能量。
And the swan in Sanskrit is called Hamsa. And the swan is able to distinguish between what is material and what is spiritual.
天鹅它的梵文词叫做 Hamsa. 天鹅的意思是一个能够区分物质与灵性的人。
Yeah, and the swan knows he can understand what's the cause of bondage and the cause of liberation.
而且这个天鹅它所意指的这样一个人，他既能够了解束缚的方法，也能既知道什么是束缚的，既知道什么是能够帮助我获得解脱的。
So all the scriptures, they're made up of very different sound vibrations.
所有的经典都是由这所有的经典的话语组成的各种各样的音阵。
So if somebody doesn't study the scriptures,that just if somebody gives up the study of the scriptures just to do material activities, then he's very foolish.
如果一个人他对这些经典置之不理，而总是从事的一些物质活动的话，他是愚蠢的。
Prabhupada explains that how our Krishna consciousness movement, we're trying to present the Vedic knowledge.In all the different languages of the world.
Shrim Prabhupada 解释到，我们的 Krishna 知觉运动非常渴望，就是把伟达知识呈现到世界上各个地方，以各种语言呈现到世界的各个地方。
And Prabhupada mentions languages like English, French, German.
比如说有英语、法语、德语。
And he said, Prabhupada said, in the Western world, people are very attracted to temporary activities for material progress.
Shrim Prabhupada 解释到，这些西方国家，他们非常热衷于从事物质活动，以获取物质的进步。
So Prabhupada said, anybody who's sane, they can understand these activities are important for.Material life, but not for eternal life.
任何一个明智之人都能领悟到这些活动对物质生活是很重要，但是与永恒的灵性生活是没有关系的。
And Prabhupada says how people in other parts of the world, they like to follow what people in the West are doing.
而且世界上的所有的其他国家都在追随着这些西方文明、西方国家。
So Prabhupada said, our Krishna consciousness movement wants to give the Vedic knowledge to these Western people so that they can give it to the people in all the other countries of the world.
所以圣帕帕德解释到，我们的 Krishna 知觉之所以想非常希望能够把这门 Krishna 知觉给予西方的国家。这样西方的国家可以把这门知识传遍到世界的其他地方。
We have to know what is important in life.
我们得了解生命之中重要的是什么事情。
We can easily be put into darkness and struggle for our existence.
我们很容易就被处到黑暗和挣扎之中。
So people in the West, they see how the young people,are become very degraded and they grow their hair long and their dirty clothes, although they have university education, but still they appear so degraded.
西方人当时虽然他们受过很多看他们的这些年轻人当时虽然受过很好的教育，但是他们看起来总是那么的堕落，他们留着长发，而且 反正就是很堕落。
So Krishna consciousness movement tried to change these people to make them serious devotees.
而 Krishna 知觉就是为了改变这些人，让他们变得严肃认真起来，严肃起来。
And teach them about how to perform welfare activities for the benefit of the world.
而且教导他们如何从事那些对整个人类社会都非常有帮助的事情。
Then Narada Muni had also spoken that there was a physical object which was made of many blades, very sharp blades and thunderbolts.
Narada Muni 还解释过有这么一个物体，它是由剃刀和霹雳组成。
And they understand it, it's understood like this, that eternal time is made like, is like razors and thunderbolts.
Parayashva, 他们这么理解到，永恒的时间，他们就好像剃刀和霹雳一样。
Because eternal time is very sharp, and it's just like razors and thunderbolts.
因为永恒的时间它非常的锋利，就像剃刀一样。
And it's uninterrupted, and it is independent.
而且独立的，没有永不停止的。
And if we don't understand the nature of time, then we won't get any benefit from doing any material activity.
如果我们不研究永恒的这个时间，我们总是从事这些物质活动的话，我们也不会得到任何的益处。
So we have to understand how time moves so fast. It does not wait for anyone.
时间总是流淌的非常的快，它不会等待任何一个人。
And even a moment cannot be bought back for millions of dollars.
即便你花上数百万美元，你也换不回一刻的光阴。
So if we waste our time for nothing, then we're very foolish.
如果我们虚度这个时间，我们是非常愚蠢。
If we live like an animal, we don't understand the goal of life.
如果我们像动物一样的活着，不了解生命的目标的话。
And if we think there is no eternity, there's no eternal life anywhere.
而且如果我们认为没有永恒，也没有永恒的生命的话。
And we may think that just to get a life in the material body, 50, 60, or at the very most even 100 years, then that's everything, that's very good.
如果我们认为这一生只有五六十年，最多只有一百年的话，这是非常愚蠢的。
So that is the greatest foolishness to think like that. You have to be very stupid to think like that.
如果我们都是这么去认为的话，没有永恒的话，这是最大的愚蠢。
We have to understand time is eternal.
我们需要了解时间是永恒的。
And the material world, we go through different phases of eternal time.
我们在物质世界只是度过人生的不同的阶段。
So the time is compared to the sharp razor. Just like the razor is very sharp to shave the hair from our face.
时间被比喻为锋利的剃刀。剃刀是为了刮掉我们身上的我们脸上的这个胡须。
But if we don't take care of the razor, if we don't handle it very carefully, we can easily get cut, and then it's very difficult to stop the bleeding.
如果我们非常不小心的用这个剃刀的话，这个剃刀很容易就把脸割破，然后不停的流血。
So we should use every moment of our time for Krishna consciousness.
我们需要很小心地利用好每一个片刻去服务 Krishna.
So Narada Muni asks how one can ignorantly, how we can be so ignorant to disobey the instructions of our own father.
那儿的穆里曾经说到，一个人怎么能愚蠢地去反抗自己的父亲呢？
So the Haryashvas, they understood this question. They understood it to mean that how to accept the original instructions of the scriptures.
Haryashva, 他们也理解，人理解这个含义就人应该接受经典的原始的训示。
According to the Vedic culture, somebody is given the second initiation, we're given the sacred thread.
根据伟达文明，有一些人会被授以圣限，接受二次启迪。
So we take the second birth due to taking instructions from the scriptures, from the spiritual teacher.
我们接受启迪意味着实际上意味着的是我们从灵性导师那里接受经典的训示。
So Shastra or scripture is the real father.
经典是我们真正的父亲。
And all the scriptures tell us we should finish material life. We shouldn't want to take birth again in the material world.
所有的经典训示，人应该终止物质的生命之途，离开这个物质世界。
If we don't know the purpose of our father's instructions, meaning the scriptures, then we're ignorant.
如果我们不知道我们的父亲，也就是经典的命令的话，那就是愚蠢。
And the material father always tries to get his son.To do material activities.
物质的父亲总是让他的儿子从事那些物质的活动。
But that's not the real instruction of the father.
但那不是真正的父亲所应该给予的训示。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna also describes that the demons, they're not really.Human beings, they don't know the meaning of what they should do and what they should not do.
国家梵歌中说到，恶魔比人类差，他们不知道什么该做，什么不该做。
In the material world, everyone wants to lord over the material nature.
在这个物质世界之中，每一个人都想称霸物质世界。
This desire to enjoy the material world, this is called pavritti marg.
这种享受物质世界的这种愿望被称为 pavritti marg.
But the scriptures also tell us that if we want to get free from the material way of life, we should do nivritti marg.
但是经典也告诉了我们如果我们想从物质生活之中解脱出来，他告诉了我们这条道路被称为 Nirvriti Marg。
So other scriptures also agree on this.
其他的很多经典也赞同这两种道路和方法。
Just like in the Buddhist scriptures.Lord Buddha says that we should achieve nirvana.
就像在佛教的教义之中，主佛陀告诉我们，人应该去达到 nirvana 涅槃的这个境界。
And we can get there by giving up the material way of life.
而要达到涅槃，人应该放弃物质主义生物质主义之途。
And in the Bible.The Bible is also Shastra. We get the same advice.
在圣经之中同样也有同样的教导。
In the Bible it says we should give up material life and we should go back to the kingdom of God.
圣经之中告诉我们人应该终止物质主义生活重返灵性的神的王国。
So in the Vedas the same advice is given.That we should give up the material way of life and we should go to the original spiritual life.
这些教导都和伟达经给我们的教导一样，我们应该终止物质主义的生活，回到灵性的生活之中。
And Shankaracharya also says, material world is false and only the Brahman is truth.
Shankaracharya 也给出了同样的结论，说物质主义生活完全是假象，灵性的 Brahman 是真正的。
So you can see how all these different scriptures are all saying the same thing.
我们看到所有的这些不同的经典，他们其实也说着同样的事情。
And the Vedas is made up of the Samaveda, Yajurveda, Rigveda, Atharvaveda, four Vedas. So the Vedas, they also give us knowledge.
伟达经有四部 Samaveda, Yajurveda, Rigveda 以及 Atharvaveda， 他们都给予知识。
And Bhagavad Gita is the essence of that Vedic knowledge.
博迦梵歌是所有这些伟达知识的精华。
And so everybody should accept that teaching of the Bhagavad Gita.
每一个人都应该接受博迦梵歌的教导。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says we should give up all other duties and just surrender unto Him.
在《博迦梵歌》中，主 Krishna 亲自说道：“一个人应该放弃所有其他的职责，只应该臣服于他。”
And we should be initiated, following the principles of the Shastra.
我们应该接受启迪，并遵守经典中的训示。
And Prabhupada explains that in our Krishna consciousness movement, if people want to get initiation, they have to accept the advice of the speaker of the Shastra. They have to accept the advice of Krishna.
Shrim Prabhupada 说，如果我们要接受 Krishna 知觉中的启迪的话，我们应该接受主 Krishna 以及经典中给予我们的训示。
And we have to forget about material life.
我们应该忘记这些物质的生活。
So that means we have to forget about illicit sex, intoxication, gambling, meat eating. These things have to be given up.
忘记物质生活意味着是我们要放弃与非法性生活，不吸食麻醉品，赌博，鱼肉蛋等等这些罪恶的这些行为。
And if we give these things up and take shelter of bhakti yoga, then we can go back to Godhead.
如果我们放弃这些罪恶的活动，然后脱避于奉爱瑜伽之徒的话，我们就可以回归受身。
So it said every living entity has a father and mother. It doesn't matter if you are a cat or a dog or a snake, you have a father and mother.
每一个个体生物它都有它的父亲和母亲，无论是猫狗还是其他的等等的这些，包括这些小昆虫，它们都有自己的父母。
So birth after birth,we get a body and we'll get a father and mother to provide us the body.
一世复一世，我们得到一个躯体，然后我们得到一个父亲母亲，得到我们的父母。
So if we feel happy with our father and mother in the material body, then we won't make any progress in our spiritual life.
如果我们满足于我们的这个父母，只是在一世复一世的生活中满足于我们的父母，而不去接受，而不去思考这些灵性的话，我们不会向前迈进，得到进步，在这个人类生活之中。
So we'll just remain in Maya, material energy.
那么我们还处在物质能量的 Maya 之中。
So the material mother and father are.Important if we are interested in material education.
物质的父母总是非常注重于孩子的物质方面的教育。
But if we want to educate our son to get free from birth and death, then not very important.
Sorry, Gurudev.
If we want to get free from birth and death, then the mother, material mother and father are not very important.
如果这个父母不能够帮助孩子把他从生死轮回之中解脱出来的话，那么这样的父母不是那么的重要。
Lord Rishabhdev has already said in the Srimad Bhagavatam, he said, don't become a father and mother unless you can deliver your children from birth and death.
主 Rishabhdev 的教导说，如果你不能把你的孩子从这个生死轮回之中解脱出来的话，那么不要试图成为父母。
If we cannot save our children from birth and death, then we're no different from the cats and dogs.
如果我们不能把孩子从生死轮回中解脱出来的话，那么和猫狗这样的情况又有什么不一样呢？
Yeah, the real parents, they will be able to bring their children to the spiritual platform.
真正的父母能够把他们的孩子带到灵性的层面。
So we get a mother and a father, and the purpose of life is to become a brahmana. We want to become first class.
我们有父母，但我们的生命，然而我们的生命是要成为婆罗门，是成为一个一流的人。
So to become a brahmana, we have to know the supreme Brahman. We have to know the absolute truth.
要成为 brahman, 我们得了解绝对真理。
And we want to know that, we have to approach a guru, we have to have a spiritual teacher who will teach us, who will initiate us and give us this knowledge.
要成为一个 Brahmana, 我们得需要一位灵性导师，接近一位灵性导师，需要他来教授我们这个灵性的知识。
And he'll give the disciple the Brahmana thread and he'll teach him to chant the mantra.
他会启迪门徒，给予圣贤，然后给予Brahmana 的这个曼陀罗。
So, after becoming a Brahmana, then he can do yagya.
当他能够成为一个 Brahmana, 一个 Brahmana 的时候，他于是可以做这个祭祀。
And after initiation, then we can study the scriptures.
当他得到启迪的时候，他能够理解经典。
And scriptures will tell us how to get out of material life and how to go back to Godhead.
他研习经典，经典会告诉他们，会告诉他如何离开物质生活，如何返回家园。
So Krishna is teaching us the Krishna consciousness movement is teaching us this knowledge, how to get freed from birth and death.
Krishna 知觉的这个运动就是在告诉我们如何摆脱生死。
But although we're giving this knowledge, often the parents of our devotees are not happy with our movement.
虽然我们给予了这门知识，但是很多奉献者的父母他们并不满意这门知识。
They say we should teach our students how to make money.
他们觉得我们应该教我们的孩子如何去挣钱。
And sometimes the business people who are businessmen who are doing business, they also don't like our movement because we don't take intoxication, we don't eat meat, we don't do illicit sex or gamble. So these kind of people, they don't like us.
有很多商人对我们的Krishna 知觉运动也很不满，因为 Krishna 我们的运动教导人们不要吸食麻醉品，不要吸毒，不要吃鱼肉蛋，不要过非法性生活，也不要去赌博，所以这些商人对我们也很不满。
Because if we spread Krishna consciousness, then these businessmen they'll have to close down their slaughterhouse, they'll have to close down their beer houses and their cigarette factories.
他们觉得如果我们的 Krishna 知觉运动传播开来，这些商人就不得不关闭屠宰场、啤酒厂，还有这些烟厂。
So they're very much these people, these businessmen, they're afraid of us.
所以这些商人们都非常害怕我们。
But we, Prabhupada, we have to teach our devotees how to get free from materialistic life.
圣帕帕的说，我们得教导我们的奉献者，我们如何从物质生活之中，我们应该如何从物质生活之中得到解脱出来。
We have to save them from birth and death.
我们得拯救他们脱离生和死之间。
So Narada Muni told these Haryashvas, he told them that instead of getting married and having children, it's better to leave and just become perfect in your own spiritual understanding.
Narada Muni 其实在告诉这些 Haryashvas 们，最好不要去繁衍后代，最好现在就离开，按照经典的训示去获得灵性的觉悟以及完美。
We should understand what is the instruction of the scriptures.
我们需要了解到底经典给我们的训示是什么。
We should know what the scriptures tell us to do, and we should do.According to the scriptures, we shouldn't just do what we like.
我们得做一些经典告诉我们应该做的事情，而不是做那些我们想走想做什么就做什么的那些事情。
If we just do what we like, then we will never get perfection, and we will never have happiness, and we will never go back to the spiritual world.
如果我们随心所欲地做我们想做的事情，我们永远也不会得到完美，我们永远也不会快乐，我们永远也不会回归守身。
So after Narada Muni had spoken all this, then the sons of Daksha, the Haryashvas, they were very convinced, and they believed his teachings, and they agreed with everything Narada Muni said.
当 Haryashva 听到了 Narada Muni 所说的这一席话之后，他们都被说服了，对此坚信不疑，而且相信他的结论。
So they circumambulated Narada Muni, and they accepted him as their spiritual master, and then they followed the path by which they never come back to this material world.
而且他们还接受 Narada Muni 为他们的灵性导师，他们。并遵循这条纳尔德穆里所说的这条道路，永不重返这个物质世界的这条道路的这条途径。
So we should understand the duty of the spiritual master and the duty of the disciple.
从这里我们要了解灵性导师的职责以及门徒的职责是什么。
So the spiritual master will never tell the disciple.That I will give you a mantra and you pay me some money.
灵性导师从不会告诉他的门徒说，我给你一个曼陀罗，你给我一点钱。
And he's not going to tell the disciple that you just practice this yoga and you'll become very expert in material life.
灵性导师也不会这么说，你念这个瑜伽，你就能在物质生活之中得心应手。
The spiritual master's duty is to teach the disciple to give up material life.
灵性导师的职责是告诉门徒如何摒弃物质主义的生活。
And the disciple's duty is to understand these instructions and to follow these instructions.
而门徒的职责是理解他的训示，理解灵性导师的训示，并遵循他的训示。
And by following these instructions, then they will go back to Godhead. They will never take birth again in the material world.
只有遵循灵性导师的训示，他才能够回归守神，再也不会违反这个物质世界。
So the Haryashvas had heard all these instructions of Narada Muni, and they decided.They didn't want materialistic life.
Haryashva 听到这纳尔达穆尼所说的这些之后，他并不想要这些物质主义的生活。
they decided they didn't want to go back and get married and have hundreds of children and have to take care of them.
他决定不这些儿子们决定不再想回去，接受妻子繁衍孩子并照顾这些孩子们。
They knew if they did all that, then they would get very entangled in the material world.
如果他们这些哈尔亚什瓦这些一万个儿子们，他们知道，如果他们从事了这些活动的话，他们会非常束缚于这个物质世界之中。
So these Haryasvas, they didn't worry about what was pious or what was impious.
Haryasvam, 他们不考虑什么是虔诚和不虔诚的活动。
Their father was Daksha, and Daksha had told them to increase the population.
他们的父亲是 Daksha, Daksha 给他们的训示，让他们增加人口。
But,Because of Narada Muni's instructions, they couldn't follow the instructions of their father.
但由于 Narada Muni 给出的训示，所以哈尔亚什瓦们他们无法遵循 Daksha 的训示了。
Narada Muni gave them instructions from the scriptures so that they could give up the material world.
Narada Muni 给出的这个训示让他们摒弃这个物质世界。
And because they were good devotees, they followed Narada Muni's instructions.
由于哈尔亚什瓦们他们是好的奉献者，所以他们遵循纳尔达穆尼的训示。
So they didn't even go to the different planets in the universe.
他们甚至不去宇宙之中的各种不同的星系去游荡。
Because even if they had gone to the top planet in the material world, in their universe, top planet is the planet of Brahma, still they have to come back again. So materialistic people, they waste a lot of time going up to the in the material world, then coming down, then going back up. They never get free of birth and death.
物质主义者他们花费了大量的时间去到上面，然后再回到下面。他花费了大量的时间去做这些事情。
So we should always remember the goal of life is to return home, to go back to Godhead.
我们应总是铭记，我们的目标是回归守神，回到守神那去。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, from the highest planet in the material world, which means the planet of Brahma, down to the lowest, they're all places of misery.
So Krishna 在佛家梵歌中说，从物质世界的最高星宿到最低星宿，都是痛苦。
Everywhere there's birth and death.
到处都充满了生和死。
But if somebody comes to the abode of Krishna, if we come to Krishna's place,Then we will never take birth again.
如果有人能够回到 Krishna 的地方，那他再也不会投身在这个物质世界。
We have to just make sure we get Krishna's abode, nowhere else.
因此，我们应该投身在 Krishna 的星球上，而不是其他的别的地方。
Okay, we'll stop here.
Okay, 我们现在讲到这儿。
Are there any questions?
Not yet.
Okay, so.
萨提马拉吉，我们现在还没有看到问题，是吗？哦，他可能现在有点忙。
没有问题。
OK，
行，你上来。
对对对。Not yet. Good.
OK, so Narada Muni has been telling us about these sons of Daksha. He wants them not to go back, not to stay in the material world.
Tell the Haryashva not go back, just stay in the material world.
Not to stay in the material world, to get out of this material world.
Okay. Narada Muni 告诉 Haryashva 不要待在这个物质世界，要从这个物质世界之中离开，想办法。
But he didn't tell them directly that. He gave it all in a big analogy. He described so many different allegorical things to them.
Hare Krishna Guru, just a break. Can you speak again?
Oh, that Narada Muni did not say directly what he wanted them
yes.
to do.
Narada Muni 没有直接的那么去说。
He gave many examples.
他给出了很多的例子。
And he knew they were intelligent, they would understand the meaning.
因为Narada Muni知道他们是很有智慧的，所以他们能够理解这些事情。
Of course, Daksha, their father, is not going to be very pleased.
当然，他们的父亲Daksha不会对此感到满意。
So it's always this is a common problem between the material father and the spiritual father.
这是一个很普遍的问题，存在于物质的父亲和灵性的父亲之间的。
Now, if you ask your material mother and father, then they will also tell you, they will encourage you in your material life.
如果你问你的物质的父亲和母亲的话，他们总是会让你们去在这个让你们留在这个物质的世界。
They will say, "Oh, you have to have children, you have to get married, you have to have a home, you have to enjoy material life."
他说：“哦，你应该结婚，你应该有孩子，你应该有一个家庭，你应该有你的这些物质的生活。”
What they're saying is, I have suffered all these things, you should also suffer.
他们实际所说的这个意思是，我遭受了这么一切，你也应该经历这一切事情。我经历了这一切事情，你也应该遭受这一切事情。
They don't admit that it was suffering, but it's a fact.
虽然他们嘴上不会说他们在遭受，他们遭受的这些痛苦，但是这实际上是一种事实。
One time, there's a in the fairground, there's this one booth, and you have to pay money to go in, and they say you get the most wonderful experience.
Sorry, Guru Dev.In the ground.
In the fairground, you know the fairground, you know the entertainment. It's an entertainment thing. They have different activities for people. They come and enjoy. You know, it's usually it's a temporary thing which comes. People like to enjoy. They go to visit this thing and.There will be different tents there. And there's a tent, one tent. And so they're inviting people. You come in behind this tent and you will get the most wonderful experience.
在这个一片土地上，人们喜欢从事着各种各样的活动。于是有人就有这个人就说，你来到这儿，你可以得到第一手的这个体验，你赶紧来，你能得到第一手的体验。
And what is that enjoyment? They say, oh, you come, you pay the money, and then you'll find out.
然后有人就问这个人说，我来到这儿能够得到什么样的享受和体验呢？这个在这里负责这个人就说，你来花了钱你就能知道了。
So one man volunteered, said, okay, I'll pay the money, and he went in, and he said, okay, you go in there, in that door, go in there.
于是就有一个志愿者就拿着钱就过来了，他说，好，那我去体验一下。然后这个人就说，那有个门，你进去吧。
Okay, so the man went in the tent. He went into that tent in the back there of the tent. He went in there, and there's another man there. And the man had a big stick, and he hit him with a big stick.
当这个男的进去了之后，他发现有另外一个男人拿着一个棍子，他拿着这个棍子就要去打他。
And the man came out, and all his friends said, "How was it?" And the man said, "Oh, very good, very nice. You should go."
所以当这个男的出来了之后，周围其他的朋友都问他，你刚刚进去有什么体验啊？这个男的就说，哦，进去之后的体验非常好，你们应该也去试一试。
So second man went, and same thing happened. He went in, he paid the money, went in, and the man in the back of the tent hit him with a big stick, walloped him, beat him on the back.
所以当第二个男的进到这个帐篷里面去了之后，同样的事情也发生了，有一个人拿着这个棍子准备要打他的背后。
The man came out, and all the men were there. He said, "So, how was it?" He said, "Oh, wonderful, very good. You must go."
所以当这个第二个男的出来了之后，其他的朋友也在问，你进去了感觉之后什么样的感觉？他说，非常好的体验，你们一定得去试一试。
So in this way, one after another, all the different men went. They paid the money.And they all got beaten. And after they got beaten, they all came out and they said, "Oh, very nice."
所以以此类推，所有的人都进到这个帐篷里面，得到了这个体验。他们都说，哦，非常好。他们都被打了，但是他们都说非常非常好。
So material life is like that.
所以物质的这个生活就是像这样。
People don't like to admit.That it was so much suffering.
人们并不承认有那么多的痛苦。
They will say, "Oh, very nice, very nice."
他们说非常非常的好，非常好。
Oh, Maya, his business is just simply to make us suffer.
Maya 的工作就是让人们受苦。
But people are so ignorant, so foolish.They won't admit their suffering.
但是人们是如此的愚昧，如此的愚蠢，他们并不承认他们在受苦。
Struggle so hard for a little bit, tiny little bits of pleasure.
他们遭受特别特别多的痛苦，只是为了一丁点的这种享受。
Just to get a tiny little bit of pleasure.We have to suffer so much.
只是为了一丁点的享受，我们得遭受如此之多的痛苦。
So this is the meaning of material life.
这就是物质生活的意义。
So Narada Muni understood this, and he wanted to save the sons of Daksha from all the suffering.
Narada Muni 知道这个背后的真正的情况，所以他想拯救哈尔亚什瓦这一万个儿子们，拯救他们免于这种所遭受的痛苦。Hey, Joseph, I have a question.
Okay.
明白灵性导师和奉献者，让一些新会员放弃思想罪恶生活，每人念诵十分钟。开始让他们发誓坚持半年，这样开始行吗 ？Obeisance to spiritual master, we let some new members give up all the give up the four sinful activities and then let them chanting 10 minutes. Use these things as a beginning and let them swear to do these things for half years. Is that okay?
Well, I think 10 minutes is not enough.
我认为十分钟的念诵不足够。
We have to chant longer than that.
我们应该更多的念诵。
10 minutes, that's... No, no, it's not enough time. They have to chant longer than that.
十分钟太少了，我们应该让他们更多的唱诵念诵。
You should make a program that every day you can visit them on Zoom. You go to them on Zoom or on some other convenient means and you spend time to chant with them and they chant with you.
你应该组织一个线上的活动，让他们比如说 Zoom 或者说其他的一些方式，让他们跟着你一起念诵。
And this way you should chant for about an hour.
通过这样的方法，你至少应该跟他们一起念诵一个小时。
People have time. Don't worry. 10 minutes is just not enough. It's not going to... It just doesn't matter. For 6 months, 10 minutes? No, no, no. For one day, 10 minutes.And then next day 20 minutes, then next day 30 minutes.
人们其实是有时间的，你并不要去担心他们。你也可以，你只是花十分钟的话，实在是太少了。你也可以第一天十分钟，第二天二十分钟，第三天三十分钟，不断不断的增加。
We have to encourage them.And if they find it difficult to do chanting on beats, then you do kirtan with them.
如果你发现他们在念珠上和你一起念诵是很困难的，那你就和他们一起唱诵。
Get them to sing with you. You lead the chanting and they respond.
你带着他们去念诵，然后让他们去回应。
But you have to get them to associate more with the holy name.
你应该让他们更多的和圣名一起联谊。
Well, it's good they're following four principles, but that's not enough.
让他们遵循四项基本原则也很好，但这并不足够。
Four regular principles, that's material piety.
四种放弃四种罪恶生活只是一种物质上的虔诚而已。
But there's no spirituality there. Their spiritual life begins when they start to chant Hare Krishna.
但是这四项基本原则并没有灵性的成分在里面，灵性的成分源自于唱诵 Hare Krishna.
Once they're chanting Hare Krishna,Then they're beginning their spiritual life. You have to encourage them to chant more.
当他们能够唱诵 Hare Krishna 的时候，那个是他们灵性生活的开始，所以你应该让他们唱诵更多。
So don't be afraid to ask too much. Better to start high.
所以不要害怕向他们要求更多。最好的方法是让他们从一个高的起点开始。
If you ask them to just chant 10 minutes, they'll never want to increase.
如果你是对他们的要求是从十分钟开始的话，你永远不会增加了。
So you have to tell them, we're supposed to chant 16 rounds.
你得告诉他们，我们得唱十六圈。
And then if they say, "Oh, I can't do it," then they say, "Okay, how many can you do?"
如果你跟他们说十六圈，他们说我做不到的话， 那你就反问他们，那你可以做多少？
No, no, 你可以念多少？
对，你可以念多少圈？
Right, so they say, well, I could chant maybe 6 rounds. Oh, you say, well, okay, do 8 or 12. You got to push them to do more.
如果他们的回答说我只能念六圈，那你就得跟他们说不行不行，八圈、十圈、十二圈，你得强迫着他，你得推着他们，推着他们做更多。
Just like if you're selling a motor car, you don't want to go to the lowest price, you want to know what's the highest price you can sell the car for.
如果你是卖一个摩托车的话，你不会开始想去卖那个最低价钱，你开始要卖的是卖最高价钱。
Prabhupada asked the devotees to chant 64 rounds in the beginning.
圣帕帕德在最开始的时候是让人们念64圈。
He didn't say chant 10 minutes. He said chant 64 rounds.
他并没有一开始就说你们念十分钟，你们一开始就给我念64圈。
And when the devotees couldn't do it, then he said, okay, then do 32 rounds.
当奉献者实在做不了六十四圈的时候，他说：“好吧，那就念32圈。”
And then he still couldn't do it. So then he said, "Okay, then you have to do at least 16 rounds, and we cannot reduce it anymore."
然后奉献者说32圈也做不了了，圣帕帕德才说：“那我们就念16圈，再也不能减少到16圈以下了，最最低限度是16圈。”
You understand?
你理解吗？
So think big, don't think so small. 10 minutes, oh, Krishna.
你把你的想法放大一点，不要想得太小。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Yogita Sharma. Mother, Hare Krishna Gurudev, please accept my humble obeisance, all glory to you Gurudev, Srila Prabhupada, and devotees online. When a person is ready chanting another mantra, and we ask them to chant the Hare Krishna mantra, which has directly been given by the Lord, but such new people's belief is not yet so strong in those words, and they say we are comfortable and feeling good by chanting this normal mantra. What more can I say to a person saying like this, Gurudev? Shall appreciate your guidance.
They're chanting what mantra?
Sorry.
What mantra?
Let me. I don't know. She didn't mention. Let me translate first. Hare Krishna, Gurudev, 请接受我卑微的顶拜。当一个人准备要念诵当一个人已经念诵其他的曼陀罗，然后我们让他们念诵 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗的时候，当我们让他们念 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗的时候，但是这个人他的信念并没有那么的强大，然后他们说，我念诵这个以前的曼陀罗非常的舒适，然后也感觉到非常的好，所以我应该怎么样对这样的一个人回复？谢谢 Gurudev. Gurudev, she didn't mention this normal mantra, which normal mantra?
Well, you have to ask him, is it the names of the Lord? Are they chanting the names of the Lord?
所以你得问一问他们是不是唱念诵的这个主的名字。
And who gave him the mantra? Is the mantra coming? Is it coming through the disciplic succession?
到底是谁给予他们这个 mantra 呢？是不是来自于师徒传承呢？
If the mantra is not coming through the disciplic succession, and if he wasn't given the mantra by, then he won't get any fruit. It won't bear any result.
如果他们所得到的这个曼陀罗并不是来自于师徒传承，他们唱诵这个曼陀罗不会有任何的结果。
It is stated, Sampradaya Vihina ye mantraste nishphalamata, that you have to receive the mantra through the disciplic succession before it can bear any fruit.
除非我们从一个师徒传承那里接受这个曼陀罗，否则我们不会有任何的结果。
So, of course, some people, they don't want to take instruction, so sometimes it's just a waste of time.
有一些人也不喜欢，就是说有一些情况是有一些人他并不喜欢接受建议，所以对于他们来说也是浪费时间。So to talk philosophy
is not very useful to them. It's better just to give them some prasadam.
所以对于这样的人讲这个哲学也没有用处，最好是给他们一些prasadam。
Tell them, oh, it's very nice, you're a spiritual person, you're chanting a mantra, very good. You can praise him. Tell the man, no, it's very good, you're chanting a mantra, very nice, and very
good. 你可以赞扬他们，就是说，哦，你也在唱诵曼陀罗，非常好。
In this way, make the man feel a little more receptive. Don't always be attacking people and condemning them and threatening them and telling them that they're all wrong and, you know, try to see what you've got in common with them. Try to get them on your side.
所以通过这样的表扬他们的方式，让他们觉得你是接纳他们的，你是和他们在一边的，而不是用说你是错的，你是怎样来这样攻击他们、指责他们。不要这么做。
Try to just to encourage them.
尽量的去鼓励他们. Then this Mataji said, I didn't ask her to give up chanting her normal mantra, but to add Hare Krishna mantra. But yet they may be the reply. So please advise, how may I reply?
So I told you that you reply that that is nice, they're chanting a mantra, very good.
所以我告诉你的这个回复的方法是，你告诉他们，你们唱诵这个曼陀罗也是很好的。And she also said, and Gurudev, Bombay being under lockdown, she does not have the Tushi Mala. So what may I ask her to chant on? On the other beat, she has may not been 108 beats.
Who is this?
Yogita Sharma.
She doesn't have beats? Who doesn't?
Bombay being not locked down. She doesn't have the Tushi Mala. So what may I ask her to chant on?
Well, she can chant on any other beats.
She said any other beats may not have the 108 beats.
Well, count how many beats are on it, and then calculate how many rounds they have to do.
就是说，他可以用任何其他的念珠念，但是，如果没有108个的话，就让他们计数到底念多少个，然后念了多少圈。
Right, if their beats only have 54, then they have to chant 32 rounds.
如果他们的念珠只有54的话, 他们可以唱32圈。 Okay, next question. Next question from Vaishnavi Vani, Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. I was thinking why Narada Muni didn't tell them to do devotional service while living a married life, and they can still go back to Godhead like Ambarish Maharaj, Jua Maharaj. Thank you, my humble basis. Vaishnava Bani Mataji, 这个问题是 Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. 我在想，Narada Muni为什么没有告诉这些儿子们，让他们继续从事奉献服务的同时，过一个居士的生活。 他们同样也可以回归守身，比如说像 Ambarish Maharaj、Jua Maharaj 等等那样我卑微的顶拜阿育吠舍。
Well, Narada Muni is a brahmachari, so naturally he's inclined for people to follow a similar path to him.
Narada Muni is a 真守身 brahmachari, so he has a 天然的给出的这个建议跟他的情况是一致的。
He thought they're such nice young men, why do they need to have family life?
他们认为这些都是非常好的年轻的男孩子，为什么要让他们进入到家庭生活之中呢？
It's also risky. Where are you going to get 10,000 women? You've got 10,000 nice men. Where are you going to get 10,000 qualified women?
而且我们到哪里去寻找这一万个非常优秀的有品质的女人呢？所以这样的情况下也是非常危险的。
Narada Muni considered better, let them just stay away from home. Don't go back home. Don't go into family life. Just go back to Godhead.
所以 Narada Muni 给考虑的更深远，他希望他们就这样离开，不要进入到家庭生活，远离家庭生活，回归守身。
They'd already progressed so far.They didn't
need 而且这样也会更深远的进步。
No need to go back, want to go forward.
他们不用回去，他们只需要往前继续前进就好了。
They were already advanced.On the path of transcendence.
他们已经在超然的层面上，超然的道路途上了。
They had no desire for family life.
而且他们也没有家庭生活的愿望。
So they wouldn't be very happy in that family life.
如果他们回到家庭生活中，他们也不会快乐。
And they go to family life, how long can they stay there? Cannot stay there very long.
如果他们回到家庭生活，他们也不会待很长的时间。
So grihastha life is only one part of the life. You have to finish the grihastha life and then you have to work for transcendence.
居士生活又能有多长时间呢？我们应该结束这个居士生活，然后去到更超然的这个层面，去到超然的层面。
So, Krishna consciousness, we said, you know, there's two kinds of brahmacharis. Some brahmacharis, they'll go back and they'll get married, and other brahmacharis, they'll just go on, they won't go into family life.
有两种 brahmachari， 第一种他是回到居士生活中，进入到居士阶段；还有一种 brahmachari， 他继续往前走，回归守身。
So these Haryasvas, the 10,000 sons of Daksha, they were the brahmacharis who didn't need to go to family life. They were already qualified to go on. They didn't need to go into family life.
所以这些哈尔亚什瓦这一万个儿子，他们都是非常有资格的，他们不必再去到婚姻生活之中，他们可以继续在 brahmachari 的真守的这个生活中继续前进。
There will always be other people. They want to get married. They want to have a wife. Okay.
总是有那么一些人，他们希望有家庭生活。好的，也是可以的。
But these 10,000 men, they didn't have that desire. They were not thinking of that.
但是这一万个儿子，他们并没有这么想，他们并不想去到家庭生活。
So Narada Muni thought, what's the point of them going back to family life? It's not necessary.
所以 Narada Muni 给予他们的建议是，去到家庭生活中有什么用处呢？对于你们而言没有必要。 next question.
Yeah.
Yeah, next question from Jiang Yuwen, David Nassi. 顶拜公路和翻译，您修了几年，越来越感觉到这个物质世界是如此的痛苦。快乐总是很短暂，例如人际关系、健康、经济状况。以上这些出现的失衡时候，就会陷入到痛苦之中。请问咕噜，在生活中遇到诸多的考验，和麻烦的时候，应该怎样做才能心意丝毫不受到打扰？谢谢。A basis to guru and practice Krishna consciousness for some years, and I more and more feel about this material world is so much suffering, and the happiness are very temporary, like the relationship, health, and economy. So when I find some troubles on these things, and feel not feel unbalanced, I fall into the sufferings. So I want to ask a guru, in our life, in my life, when I find some tests and troubles, how can I do and that my mind can not be disturbed? Thank you.
You have to take shelter of Lord Krishna by chanting his holy name.
你得通过唱诵圣名托庇于 Krishna.
Krishna conscious, Lord Krishna is the real shelter from all the miseries of the material world.
主 Krishna 是所有是在这个痛苦的物质世界之中唯一的真正值得托庇的对象。
So you just have to, when the material energy is very powerful, when you feel it more, the effect of the material energy, then you have to call to Krishna.
当你被这个物质能量强烈的受到它的影响，被它影响的时候，你应该呼唤 Krishna。
Oh Maya, here's Maya coming. Oh Krishna, help me, save me. And you call out, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So this is the real shelter from the material world.
当物质能量强烈的攻击你的时候，你应该呼唤着 Oh Krishna。然后你唱诵着 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗，你应该感觉到这个 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗是我们在这个物质世界唯一的托庇的地方。
So you have to practice this constantly.
你得一直不断的练习这一件事情。
You have to know there's no shelter in the material world other than the lotus feet of Lord Sri Krishna.
你得了解到在这个物质世界除了主 Krishna 之外没有其他任何的庇护所。
Okay, so...
Okay, next question.
Yeah.
Tejas Prabhu 说谢谢 Guru. Next question from Hani Vamsa, 顶拜 Guru. 帕帕德居士时期做生意也是64圈吗？曾听奉献者说，帕帕分享过自己的军事经验是中晚饭晚前各四圈，那么加起来不是十六圈，而是加起来不是十六圈，不是64圈，怎么确认帕帕的军事念十六圈还是64圈 ？OK， a basis to guru.I heard Srila Prabhupada, when he in his Grihastha life, he do some business. Does he also chanting the 64 rounds? Because I heard from the devotees, Prabhupada said when he was a Grihastha, he chanted 4 times every day, and each time is 4 rounds. So it means that every day Srila Prabhupada chanting the 16 rounds, not the 64 rounds.So, I want to confirm 64 rounds or 60 rounds, 16 rounds.
Well, everything you say is true. That sometimes he would chant 64 rounds, And sometimes he would chant 16 rounds.
所以你说的这一切都是正确的。有时候怕怕的念诵64卷，有时候他念诵16卷。
It would depend on time and circumstance. If his time allowed, he would chant 64 rounds.
一切都取决于他自己的时间和情况。有，如果时间允许的话，他是念诵64卷。
Sometimes he would spend more time writing, so he would have less time for chanting.
如果他有些时候需要花更多的时间去写作的话，他会减少一些念诵的时间。
But he was always busy in Krishna consciousness.
但是他总是忙于 Krishna 知觉的这些活动。Harimamsa also asked, 我一直不明白供奉 Guru Vyasa Puja 需要用图拉西叶吗？供奉时念诵什么祷文？和供奉神像的供奉祷文是一样吗？ I always not understand when the Guru Vyasa Puja should I use the Tulsi? And when I offering the Guru Vyasa Puja of the Prasadam to Guru Vyasa Puja, what prayers should I offer? Should I offer the prayers as the offer the bhoga to the Lord the same?
Generally, we would offer whatever we offer to the guru, it will also be offered to the deities.
通常情况下，我们供奉就是供奉给 guru 的，也会供奉给神像。
First, it will be offered to the deities, then it's offered to the guru.
通常情况下，我们先供奉给神像，然后再供奉给 guru.
When you offer it to the spiritual master, then we chant the prayer to the spiritual master, and then we chant the prayer to Prabhupada, and then we chant prayer to the Lord Chaitanya, and then prayer to the Brahmanas.
When we offer the gurus, we chant this mantra, yes?
Yeah.
Okay.当我们给 Guru 供奉这个食物的时候，我们唱诵 Guru 的顶拜祷文，给帕帕德的顶拜祷文，主 Chaitanya 的顶拜祷文，以及给 Brahma 的这个祷文。
But first the food should be offered to the deities.
首先我们先把这个食物供奉给神像。
Yeah?
Okay, next question from, I don't know his name. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru 的莲花族，请问 Guru, 如果一个被第一次启迪的灵性导师，离开躯体或出现问题，之后换一个灵性导师第二次启迪，那么可以认为二次启迪的灵性导师是启迪 Guru 还是训示？二次启迪的 Guru 有责任把他带回到灵性世界吗？如果第一次启迪灵性导师，哦 ，OK， 之后换一个灵性导师二次启迪。Hare Krishna, obeisance to Guru Lotus Feet. I want to ask Guru if someone his first initiated spiritual master is leaving the body or.Have some other problems. So later he changed another spiritual master, get a second initiation. So, shall I recognize this spiritual master as the second initiated guru or as a Sheikh or Shiksha guru?And the second initiated spiritual mother have the responsibility to take these people to the spiritual world?
Yes.
是的，他有责任带回。
Second initiated spiritual master. You have to wait some time after your first spiritual master. After he's left the body, you should wait some time.You make sure he's not going to come back. He may have fallen down, but he may come back, you don't know. So usually they will wait some time before they would, unless he left the body. Of course, if he left the body, then it's okay, then you can go ahead and take initiation, take your second initiation. But you have to wait, of course. You take second initiation, you have to take shelter of someone, and then there'll be a waiting period, and then after some time, then you'll get the second initiation.
就是当你的第一个灵性导师给你第一次启迪的这个灵性导师如果离开躯体的话那是没有关系你可以找另外一个灵性导师脱壁然后取得第二次启迪但是这个也是需要等一段时间的但是当你的第一个灵性导师是出现一些比如说出现一些某些问题的时候你需要等待一段时间因为你的第一个灵性导师有可能虽然出现了问题但是有可能他纠正了他的问题他又回来了那所以这些问题都是需要考量的因此你需要等一段时间
But for spiritual master he may have had a fall down or if he left the body you can still worship him you can still keep him as your guru And you make your offerings through him.
如果你的第一个灵性导师他是离开了躯体，那么你还应该尊重他，还应该崇拜他。他还是你的灵性导师，你可以继续崇拜。
And you take this, maybe you didn't take the second initiation yet. You want to get the Brahman initiation, so you take from somebody else.
如果你想得到第二次启迪的话，婆罗门启迪的话，你可以寻找另外一个灵性导师。
And you can put the two pictures. You can have the two gurus, or if you prefer, you can just stick with the first guru.
那么这样的情况下，你可以放两个照片，或者说你可以放你的第一个灵性导师的照片。
But if he had a fall down, then you have to wait longer. He may come back, you don't know. If you've lost faith in him, then you go ahead, you can take reinitiation from somebody else.
如果你的第一个灵性导师是堕落了或出现什么问题了，那你得等更长的时间，他有可能会回来。如果他还是那种情况的话，你可以重新重新找灵性导师起。Okay, next question from Krishna Kumari, David Dasi. 顶拜 Guru 什么是奉献者之间的关爱？居士生活总是一堆的物质问题，如何近距离联谊又不落入物质躯体化的概念之中 ？A basis to Guru Day.What is the meaning of the devotees caring relation? How to care between the devotees? And the Grihastha life always have so many material problems. How to have the very close relationship association, but not fall down to the material.Temporary material conception.
How to not fall down to the temporary material conception?
First, she asked, what is the devotee care?
Well, devotee care is thinking about the welfare of the devotees, their material and spiritual well-being.
奉献者之间的关爱是关爱奉献者的物质的以及他灵性的利益。
Making sure that they have all facilities for their convenience, for their spiritual life. they should have proper association, and they're able to get their food, and they're able to practice their sadhana. Whatever difficulties they may have, devotee care is trying to help them to overcome their different problems.
确保他们在灵性生活的这些物质便利的条件是拥有的，或者说他们在灵性生活的时候，如果有物质上的这些障碍的话，比如说食物啊，比如说没有这个地方啊等等这些东西，能够帮助他们克服在灵性生活上的这些物质方面的障碍。
So, you know, devotees, we find like devotees, some devotees have given their whole life, they've surrendered everything to Krishna. Sometimes they give up everything and come to live in the temple. So, we need to make sure they're being looked after.
我们经常看到一些奉献者，他们舍弃了一切在做奉献服务，就是说是。
Sometimes single women, they have to get married, we have to arrange their marriage.
比如说还有一些单身的女性，我们也得想办法让他们想要结婚的，想让他们结婚的，帮他们结婚。
We also think about the education of children, devotee children, make sure they're getting the proper education and upbringing.
我们也得想一想那些孩子们需要接受好的一些教育以及他们的成长。
And devotee care is involved with all different aspects of all different devotees.
奉献者关爱涉及到所有奉献者的这些方方面面的事情。
So it's a very big subject.
它是一个非常宏大的问题。
Yes, and the second part was?
And the second part is, Grihastha life have always a lot of material problems. How to have an association very closely, but not fall down to the material bodily conception.
Well, we have to be very Krishna conscious, that's the point. You have to be very strong in your Krishna consciousness.
那这个要点回答你这个问题的这个要点是我们要有非常强大的 Krishna 知觉。
You have to be very steady in your hearing and chanting.
你的聆听和唱诵的这些奉献服务都是非常稳定的。
We should understand that Krishna consciousness is not for. Krishna consciousness is householder life is a great responsibility. We shouldn't abuse it.
居士生活是有承担着重大的责任的，我们不应该滥用它。
We should know how to keep our Krishna consciousness.
我们应该想着如何保持我们的 Krishna 知觉。
So you have to be very careful.
所以你也应该小心。
It's very important. It's very, very important our householders are able to show a good example to others.
非常重要的是，作为居士，应该总是展现一个好的榜样，给予其他人。They
have to be able to live together peacefully without fighting. You know, sometimes people, you know, they quarrel and argue and shout and scream and you know, their home life is very emotional and very turbulent, and it's not a good example for spiritual life.
应该非常注意，就是居士生活应该展现一个非常平和的一个榜样给予他们。 我们知道 有一些家庭，他们的这个情况就是总是双方之间总是大吼大叫，争吵来争吵去，那是一个非常一个相对比较糟糕的一个状况。
So family life, household life, it's an opportunity for spiritual advancement.
居士生活也是一个在灵性进步的一个机会。
You have to know how to take advantage of it.
因此我们应该想一想如何利用这个机会。
So we expect our devotees to show the ideal example to others.
我们希望我们的奉献者能够展示出一个给予别人的一个好的榜样出来。
Okay, so we want all devotees and family life to be very careful.To show the right example.
我们希望我们所有的奉献者应该也非常小心，展示一个正确的榜样，同时展示出一个正确的榜样。Okay, good. Question finished.
Really?
Oh, okay. Krishna Kumari just sent a message.大孩子通过读梵歌、吃菩萨等等，但还是不喜欢接近 Krishna， 可以退而求其次，往善良属性的教育系统中尽量培养他们。My big child, let him read the Bhagavad Gita and eat the prasadam, but he didn't like to.Get more close to Krishna. So can I just make him to be, 善良心态 the more goodness in his education, and make educated him. Is that okay?
He doesn't like to be Krishna conscious.
Yeah.He didn't like to be Krishna conscious, so can I educate him just to be goodness in his education? Is that okay?
Well, you have to think. What age is he?
What age? 他有多大呢 Krishna Kumari Mataji. 15, 15.
Well, certainly it's a problem. The point is the child is not yet independent. The child is depending on you for maintenance. So he's a duty to be submissive to the parent. He has to follow the instructions because the parents are providing for him.He's not working, he's not providing for himself. So he shouldn't be allowed to do just what he wants.
Okay. 你说的这个情况是一个问题，但是我要说的这个要点是，你的孩子现在还在依靠着你，他并不属于一种独立，因此他有责任，他现在其实有责任去听你所说的这一切，因为你在供养他。你不应该允许他做他随心所欲的这些事情，在你现在可以控制他的时候，你应该做，你可以训斥他一些事情。
It's always difficult bringing up children. We know it's not an easy thing.The problem is that your child was not brought up in Krishna consciousness at the beginning of life.
培养 Krishna 知觉的孩子总是很困难的，我们都知道这样的事情。 你处的这个情况的原因是你的孩子并不是在 Krishna 知觉之中长大的，他不是一开始就培养 Krishna 知觉的。Another question from I don't know this. 顶拜孤鲁，请问作为居士的奉献者，怕工作影响休息而不去工作，这样的想法对吗 ？Obeisance to Guru, I want to ask, as a Grihastha devotee, he is afraid of the material job because he thinks the material job will influence his practice of Krishna consciousness. So,this kind of idea is right.
Oh, I'm sorry. Can you say it again?
Oh, yes. I want to ask, as a Grihastha devotee, he is very afraid of job because he thinks this job will influence his practice and he don't want to do some job. So this kind of idea is right?
Well,the point is you have to have a job, you have to have some means of supporting. If you're in a family life, if you have a family and you're providing for them, you have some duties, you have some responsibilities.
这个问题的要回答这个问题的要点是，如果你是一个居士，你是一个居士，你有家庭的话，你有一个工作是你需要维系你的这个家人，你需要有一个工作维系你的家人。
It's nice you're thinking about being Krishna conscious, but at the same time, you don't want to create tension in the family.
Create tension.
Yeah, they may cause some problem in the family. The family members may object that this, you know, what you're doing, that you're giving up the job, it means you're not going to earn so much money and it's going to be difficult for the family.
就是说如果作为一个你非常好的一点是他想有他的 Krishna 知觉很稳定，但是同时他应该很清楚，他应该很注意不要引起家庭成员之间的这种紧张感，不要让他们担忧你失去了工作，你没有钱，你得依靠家人等等这样的一个情况。
So there are, you have to consider your responsibilities.
所以你也应该在意一下你的责任。
Yeah, you have a response, you want spirit, you want to have spiritual life, but you have to also take care of your duty as a family man.
你确实你想要有你的责任去维系你的灵性的生活，但是你也有责任去维系你的家庭成员。
So be careful. Don't make these kind of decisions independently and abruptly.
所以非常要小心一点，不要独自的非常突然的做这样的一个决定。
And then afterwards, then you regret it, and you're difficult to go back.
当你后悔的时候，你又很难以回去了。
You know, you may give up one job, and you took another job, and then you find this new job is not really...It's not so good, and there's a lot of problems, and you can't go back to the old job.
当你丢掉一个工作，然后你去到新的工作的时候，你又发现，哎呀，我在这个工作又不是那么的适应，然后又回到老的工作，然后又难以回到以前的这个工作，所以很麻烦。
So please be careful.
因此，请你小心。
Don't just.Do things abruptly and later on regret, and then you blame Krishna consciousness. So I did this for my Krishna consciousness, it's all Krishna's fault. So be careful.
所以请你小心，不要就是很贸然的做一些决定，然后事后又后悔， 然后因此而去责备 Krishna， 哦，我为你 Krishna 做了这样的事情，就是因为这样，然后去责备 Krishna， 这都是不好的，非常，请你小心，请小心。
Is it okay? Is it clear, Prabhu?
清楚吗？Today, I think this is 7 o'clock here now. And another question from Jai Govinda. Do you want to reply this time or next time?
What's the question?
顶拜咕噜，我经常会以家人的名义为 Krishna 买鲜花、牛奶、供奉或布施，在他们不知道的情况下做这样的服务，这是一种被动的或间接的。请问这样做我的家人会得到一些灵性的福祉吗？谢谢 Guru. A basis to Guru, I often represent my family members and represent them to buy some flowers for Krishna, buy some milk or give some donation for them, to Krishna as represent for them. So, but they didn't know. So when I do this,Can my family member get some spiritual welfare?
Yes, definitely.
当然，你的家人会得到一些好处。
Yeah, you're doing it for them. They also they will get some benefit. Very nice.
你为他们这样做，他们也会得到一些好处，非常的好。
Okay, so we'll stop here tonight. Om Ganesha Subhudirai Prabhu, Kevama Jantai Dufani, Ganesha Soya Dufang Shenzhen, Ling Ting, Ganesha Ninda Winti, Jufu Niman, Shangha Kwaila, Jui Antoine, Baldrong Shinti, Juni, Shangha Jin Khan, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Jai, Hare Krishna.
Bhagavata Vrinda Ki.
Jai.
Krishna Kumari Ki, Jai.
Jai.
Gurudev Ki Jai.
Haribol.